tails up indicators, the Xenoxis and or other axis up indicators. This is Xenoxis and this is Xenoxis for the 20s or the 27. I thought about it because I saw the time there. 31st of March 2017. So it seems like all the cars have been revealed now, because it might have been that they have not updated the new ones that they have added here. And there are some more cars here now at the end. And then there's still only three new tokens. Ugh, and there are some more cool thing. Oh wow, that for Rogue is really strong. Yeah, they're basically pushing. The thing is that they don't want Rogue to have a lot of AoE. They want Rogue to have strong single target removal. And that's supposed to be the thing that Rogues are good at. They are good at single target removal. So they're now like, here's a spell, for example, they're giving them now, which is one of the cards, Envenom Weapon, 3 mana, give your weapon poisonous. The thing is, if you have a weapon with a lot of shards, or even if you just give it to your standard dagger that has 2 shards, giving yourself poisonous is really good. So, the thing is, do you really want to attack something that has a lot of attack though, with a weapon? Since you cannot really have armor and stuff like that, but yeah. Well, that's that must be a paladin weapon, right? Yeah. It's quite expensive though, but I mean the effect is really strong. It's 7 mana, which might sound really expensive, and it's a 4-3 weapon. Which is like 7 cost, that's... Is it 7 cost for a gore howl? Yeah. What the fuck is the background noise fucking here? I can hear it here in the headset. Is that the television sounding that much? Huh, that's odd. Anyway, the wine cleave is basically a paladin weapon after you attack someone to one once if under kit. I think that's something a bit annoying, like on weapons you cannot see at all what class it belongs to. Like all weapons, the way they design them, like you cannot see the difference between a rogue weapon or a paladin weapon or a warrior weapon. All the warriors have the same kind of gray background and the same kind of art, so when they reveal cards, you know, you really have to think about it, you know, before you think, you know, which is a bit stupid, the fact that they all have the same kind of gray background, you know, the same kind of artwork pretty much, you know. Like, why isn't there something that when they just show up a weapon can, you know? Of course, you can sometimes tell by the fact. But it's, for example, Obsidian Shard costs one less for each card you played from another class. I'm guessing that has to be Rogue, because that's something that Rogues also do. But that could also be Priest, but Priests don't really have any weapons. I mean, there are only a few classes that uses weapons, so yeah. Or Bright-Eyed Scout. 4 mana, 3-4. I think this will replace a Sword Dragon, pretty much. Because that's actually a pretty insane effect. Draw a card, changes cost to 5. Okay, if it draws a cheap card, really bad. But think about it, late game, this is insane. Play this late game when you know, like, if you're using a deck track, if you're using Innkeeper, and you know, oh shit, now all the cards I have left are 7 or 8 or 9 or 10 cost cards left, then you play this. You know, you draw a 10 cost card, now it becomes 5, and then like something like, there's a 10 cost card now, 10 cost neutral common card called Ultrasaur, which is not super great. Like, sure, like, stat-wise it's pretty good, like 14 health, 7 attack. But it's 10 mana. The thing is, like, how long will it be able to last 10 mana? Like, certain 10 mana cards are really insane. But the thing is, like, this has no extra effect to it. So far, common, that's really good. But the thing is, imagine if you Bright Eyed Scout and you draw the Ultrasaur. If the Ultrasaur only costs 5 mana to play and it's a 7-14, then that's way big deal, you know. Oh, Giant Master, no, man. That one, though, I love that one. Because that one is 9 mana instead of 10. And it's a taunt. 6-10 taunt. And it's a fucking big-ass fucking mastodont, like a mammoth dinosaur. Yeah. Another Murloc here. 2 mana Rock Pool Hunter. Also common. This is a common, by the way. The Bite-Eyed Scout is purple, though. It's epic. Give a friendly Murloc 1+1+. And he's a 2-3. Oh man. And then there was an insane Murloc over here higher up. What, they're calling the Rock Pool Hunter twice? What? Wait, what? That's the same Rock Pool Hunter. Huh. What the fuck, did they do something wrong? Oh no, have they messed up their site? Oh man, there might be other duplicates then that I haven't thought about, and that's why they haven't covered all the codes yet. Like, why the fuck is Rock Pool Hunter twice? There's no difference. Ironhide, oh wow. Now they're gonna be able to play a 1-1 a card that gains 5 armor. Which, I mean, that makes the shield block one really bad. Okay, so the shield block is just a basic card, but that's gain 5 armor on my card, and draw a card is not worth 4 mana, pretty much. It's 5 mana, right? No, it's 3 mana, it costs shield block, right? Yeah, or is it? I forgot. A Primal Fiend Champion, that's a Paladin Murloc. 2 mana, 1-2. Not good stat-wise, but Death Rattler. Return any spells you cast on this minion to your hand. Which means if you adapt it, if you buff it, if you hand buff with Paladin, like a hand buffing Murloc deck is gonna become a thing. Especially when you have, like, Adaptation is now a spell also for Paladins. Adapt a friendly minion, 1 mana cost. Yeah. You know, I think they're doing it so that, like, Paladins are gonna be the main buffer style deck, basically, pretty much. You know, I like the hand buffing mechanic with means this garrison, so yeah. And the thing they're making warriors is taunt. Next, back in means it's a garrison, and I did build a deck with only taunt minions in it, which was pretty fun to play, actually. Except there's a lot of bad taunt codes, but they're getting so many insane taunt codes now for warrior. And the Fire Plume's Heart is their quest, is their class quest. 1 mana cost, it costs like a quest. Place and taunt minions. Reward is a Sulfurous Hammer, which I talked about. Here's an example of some of the taunt minions. I'm gonna go over all of them. 5 mana Direhorn Hatchling. It's a rare. It's a 5 mana 3-6 taunt. Death Rider. Shuffle a 6-9 Direhorn with taunt into your deck. So it's shovels an even stronger thing, a regular Direhorn. So basically the Direhorn dies and then it like reincarnates and comes back to kick your ass. And I believe that card, to check out how that card is, the 5-9 or the 6-9 with taunt, that's gonna show up when you check the Ungoro guide, basically, pretty much. So yeah, that's gonna be a thing. Ordinary Direhorn is another taunt minion that warriors are getting, which is a common one. A 6 mana 5-5 taunt battle cry adapt. Pretty basic, but a 6 mana 5-5, that's similar to the Shield Maiden card, which, you know, gave armor, but this one has adapt, and I mean, like, adapt, if you get 3 plus health on that, and then it's a 5-6-7-8, so then it's a 6 mana 5-8. That's actually pretty fucking good. And if you get 3 more attack on it, then it's more aggressive, then it's like an 6 mana 8-5, and, you know, like, if you get Divine Shield on it, then it's pretty bonkers, because, you know, yeah, like 6 mana 5-5 Divine Shield taunt, you know, that's pretty decent. You can give this stealth, you know, sure, then the taunt effect won't work, but then you can, for example, snipe something that you want to snipe with it, and then you can get the taunt effect when you really need it. Here's another taunt minion for warriors, a Tar Lord, which is another, like, black tar or boog or whatever, you know, like, you had the Fang Creeper in vanilla, then you had the fucking the Bog Creeper in Whispers of the Old Gods, I believe, and then now you have Tar Lord, which is a 7 mana 1-11 taunt, has 4 plus attack during the opponent's turn, so when the opponent is going to be attacking your taunt, that's when it gets the insane effect. So yeah, that's pretty fucking good. Charge Devil Sword, that's a neutral epic, really good. That's almost like a King Crush for everyone, but it cannot attack heroes. Charge Barakai, I can't attack heroes this turn, But notice the bad guys can't attack heroes this turn. So the first turn you can't attack heroes. But all the other turns after that. So if this attacks a minions, or a minion survives, if your opponent doesn't kill it next turn, it can go face. Which is fairly fucking good, you know, man. There's so many crazy good cards this time around. Like, it's just, I'm so fucking happy, man. It's just like they just throw logic out the window, you know, like. There's a lot of shit that seems like really extremely OP, but it feels like all classes are gonna have OP shit, you know, like. It's just gonna be like everything is gonna be OP almost pretty much, you know. So yeah, sudden genesis, that's another. What do you call it? 5 mana summon copies of your damaged minions. Yeah, that's really cute. If you have filled a whole board and your opponent plays something that doesn't kill everything off in one turn, then you're able to copy all the things you have, and then you most likely will have a taunt wall because warriors will be focused around taunt. So then if you get all your taunt minions back, then like, yeah, I wonder if that means that you can kill aggro decks completely if you're playing it, because there's like a lot of good neutral taunt minions as well. Like Giant Mastodon, as I said, which is the 9 mana 6/10 beast with taunt. So it's 9 mana, that's pretty expensive, you know, but yeah. Bloodbloom. I almost read this as Bloodborne. Bloodborne. Summons an unfair minion. Your opponent concedes within 3 turns automatically without them being able to do anything about it, so you just need to survive for 3 turns and then you have to win. That would be a card called Bloodborne. What else was there? I know I saw some other taunt here. Stonehill Defender is a neutral taunt. 3 mana, rare card. Taunt Battlecry, discover a taunt minion, 1/4. Discover taunt can be pretty good, you know. And unlike something like I Know a Guy, that's just a spell. This one actually puts something on the board. A 1/4 is not super strong, but the thing is, like, you can buff it with hand buff mechanics for warrior. And, you know. Then we have another one here, a really, really cheap one. A 2 mana 1/2, taunt poisonous, but that's the thing, it's poisonous. So you can play this late game. And like, if your opponent doesn't have any cheap minions left, they have to sacrifice an expensive minion to run into this. Sure, if you're going up against a weapon class, they can just weapon it to death. But they still need to waste swings on the weapon to kill something for 2 mana, you know, so that's pretty decent. They have like here primordial drake. So I think that drake or dragon call decks will be possible because there were some dragons actually. Primordial drake, taunt, battle cry, deal 2 damage to all other minions, not itself. And it's an 8 mana 4, 8 dragon. Pretty good. Pretty good. What is this taunt here? Is there any more taunt? Here's a shaman taunt. Hot Spring Guardian. I hope it's in the description reads. Pastime hobbies include watching anime girls. Because most certain type of animes always have a hot spring episode when they go to the hot spring, and then it's usually very, very lewd, you know, and stuff like that. But yeah, Hot Spring Guardian, 3 mana, 2/4, taunt, background, restore 3 health. So if you compare it to an Earthen Ring Faustus, which is a 3 mana, 3/3, restore 3 health, this doesn't have the same attack, but it has 1 more health, 1 less attack. It restores the 3 health, but also has taunt. Yeah, pretty okay, you know. Not super insane, but decent. It's decent, you know. And do we have any other taunt here that I can cover a bit quick here? There's another taunt there for, that's Warlock. Yeah, but that's the only other more taunt there. Cards with Dragons. I'm actually gonna wear one more final video. I promise this to